Good morning. It is Wednesday morning and we are midweek into our week. Wednesday, as many say, it's a small Saturdays because in the old days, my days growing up, many bank managers and people used to work until 1 o'clock on a Wednesday, and they called it the midweek, middle weekend of the weekend. Now, again, this morning, we are talking about who is holding your ladder. Now, we need to have people holding our ladder. As you know, in the beginning of the week, I showed you that clip where I took a tumble from a ladder because nobody was holding my ladder. Now, today I want to say to you, you have a responsibility to train your ladder holder. Now, there we go. Come on. So in your relationship, you need to know how to build a solid and a firm relationship by getting to know each other. You know, we get to know who God is through His Word. The Word tells us exactly who God is. And the more I read about God, the more I understand God, and the more I understand who God is and what His desire is for me and what He expects from me. Now again, when I have somebody holding my ladder, there is an expectation that I'm placing upon them that they need to keep it sturdy. They need to keep it firm. They need to have a firm hold, because the higher I go, the firmer they need to be holding the ladder below, so that I do not come into a place where it's no longer stable or safe for me to climb. Now, God has potential for each and every one of us, goals that we need to reach. You see, when God put man on the earth, He created all for man, and He gave man the responsibility of taking care of His creation, taking care of the garden. This is the responsibility. God has given us a responsibility over each other. Not so? And so we have a responsibility as Christians to be a witness of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, well, that is a responsibility that we have as well, to share the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ, again, through our lifestyle, through the way we live, through the way we talk, through the way we act, through the way we think, through the way we think and we say things. We, you know, the Proverbs says that we need to be very careful to in the things that we say, that an unwise man doesn't guard his words. He just kind of blurts them out, and as a result creates mass problem. Now, in Genesis chapter 2 verse 13, it says this: the Lord God placed man in the Garden of Eden to tend and watch over it. Notice what he gave him to do. He gave him a job to work the garden. He was a gardener. Notice that the first job man ever got in life was to be a gardener, to look after that what God had given to him, and to take care of His creation. We have to take care of this world. Now we see again that this world, He's in a mess. Our world, the environment, is really in tatters at the moment. We see pollution all over. We see air pollution. We see sea pollution. We see how they're burning down the Amazon jungles. And again, all as a result for man's own gain at the end of the day. We are not taking care of that what God has placed us to take care in and over. We're not taking care of that, of tending to this garden, this will that God has given to us, nor of His creation. Again, we see man standing up man. We hear of wars and rumors of wars. We read and we see the devastation that wars are doing to each other. There is no love. Murder is rampant every single day. Somebody is being murdered by another. Again, this is not what God has intended for man. Again, because man is not holding the ladder for each other. You see, man had a huge responsibility in the task that was set before him, a responsibility of keeping the serpent out of the garden. Notice that he had to keep the serpent out of the garden. Instead, he allowed him in. And once he allowed him in, he created chaos. Why do you think there is such chaos within the world today? Because we have allowed the serpent in by not holding the ladder for each other. You see, as soon as we take our eyes off the responsibility of taking care of that which is placed into our care, the serpent will find a way in our lives by finding our weakest link. Yeah. And again, he comes to that that area that is the weakest in our life, and that is what he attacks. Who does he normally attack? The one holding the ladder. Not so, because if he can topple the one holding the ladder, he will topple the one who is climbing the ladder. And again, we need to know our security and in whom our security is found. Notice this, in Genesis chapter 3 verse 1, it says this, "The serpent was the shrewdest of all the wild animals the Lord God had made. One day he asked the woman, 'Did God really say?'" Isn't that the problem that many of us face today? Did God really say? And as a result of that, brings doubt into our minds. And once there is doubt, we lose our focus of the one who is holding our ladder. And as a result, we fail to train that person who's holding our ladder in the ways of God, in the principles and the laws of God, of that what he has set for us of how to do life. We cannot do life outside of the Lord Jesus Christ, who has given to us Holy Spirit as our seal upon our lives, giving us that ability to hold the ladder for each other, to reach the goals that God has given to us. So again, this morning, come on, I want to ask you, do you know the person who is holding your ladder? And are you confident in their abilities of holding the ladder for you?